Are you taking yourself to the naughty corner? You're the most disciplined child I've ever seen.
You guys are not appreciating great music.
We are, and we're appreciating it in depth here on Trending SA on SABC3. As the show continues, we'll be talking about the person who we lost on this day a year ago with more music and some posts from some of his very, very good friends. All right, let us now go to Musa. Exceptional talent, best TV presenter.
So hot right now.
Ntom Benny. You can talk about Brave. You go ahead and do it.
All right. I will do it. And I'm not scared of doing it because I think it's such a great day, especially when you look back to times where someone has passed and you celebrate the life that they've lived a year later. And that's exactly what we're doing. We're looking back at that wonderful time. Now, if you don't know who this person is and you're stuck under a rock somewhere and are like, what's going on here? Well, yesterday marked the year since the legendary jazz musician Datere Phiri passed away after a long battle with lung cancer. Now, he is, of course, a self-taught guitarist, leader of the phenomenal band Stimela, and producer of gold and platinum selling albums Fire, Passion, Ecstasy, and of course Look, Listen and Decide. Now, fellow musician legend Sipho Hostix Mabuse marked this anniversary of the passing of his friend with this tweet that came through. It said, "How I want to remember hashtag Ray Piri. This lovely pic is just one memory to treasure. Look at the smiles, look at the happiness, look at the everything that's happening in that picture. Really, really great." Now, of course, Tweeps also remembered by retweeting this tweet and claiming that this was his favorite picture. Let's just retweet this hashtag Ray Piri's favorite picture, and that was from Mweli. What a beautiful picture. I must agree with that. And of course, there are some gems and of course, great music that came through. But just in case you didn't know what it was, take a listen and watch. Now, the young ones will think that's the soundtrack to Zone 14. It kinda is. But that is the original. And what a great day to remember such a great man. Now, moving on to other stories, we're looking at hashtag Thailand Cave Rescue. Mm. And that was a story that captured the world's attention for the past 2 weeks. Now, 2 weeks ago, on the 23rd of June, the Wild Boar Thai football team went missing. And the team was made up of young boys aged between 11 and 16 years old. Now, after soccer practice, the coach and the boys were looking for shelter from the torrential rains that came and found themselves getting trapped inside a cave due to the flooding. The families reported them missing. And then the search started days later when some footprints were found near the cave.
Whiz.
Quite hectic. Now, a major search as well as a rescue mission was launched, and divers found the team trapped 4 kilometers from the entrance of the cave. And the coach then decided that, you know what, it's my time to do what I need to do, and taught the boys meditation to help them keep calm and keep the nerves at bay. Sure. And the boys were then given swimming as well as diving lessons when the rescue teams did get there. Now, then finally, on Tuesday, the 10th of July, all the boys and the coach were rescued safely from the cave, and many heroes were part of this mission. But including these many heroes was South African-born Leandro Nicholas Gerardo. And Leandro helped the team, supplying them with oxygen as well as stretchers. Thank you very much to Leandro, but as well as many other people that were out there sending their prayers, their well wishes, and of course that were on the ground helping the teams out. A really, really great day that we had on the 10th of July. And we hope that as a human race, we'll get together and help each other out should something like this happen again.
Means you know also, someone who helped as well.
Yeah, well, a school friend of mine, Jason Boswell, who's also a diver and he works with one of the big broadcasters in the world. He was called out specially from Cape Town, flown to there to get into the cave. And yeah, just amazing that there are South Africans with such specific skill sets that we could add value to the rest of the world. That makes me happy.
Sure. Whenever these difficult things happen around the world, I read a quote that, you know, in wars and tough times, you always look for the helpers. You always look, because there's always someone who will risk themselves and help. Mm. And that's where you notice humanity, right? No matter what. It's 100%. Amazing. Humanity is with us because on Sunday, the World Cup is finally coming to an end.
We go to our normal time slot.
We get our boyfriends back.
Yay!
I don't want mine back. I mean, what?
I brought mine to work.
Okay, guys. And we get to, you know, carry on with the things that make the pots to be. But let me tell you, this World Cup has been unbelievable. Germany out. Spain out. Brazil out. Bafana, Bafana.
Huh?
Huh?
Sorry.
They weren't there.
Shh. But I must say, some incredibly interesting things have happened that made this World Cup more like a theatrical performance rather than, you know, a football World Cup. We had Mr. Roland on the ground, Neymar. Famous now in fried chicken commercials.
Yes.
Father Powder, Mr., you know, faint it all, Mr. Is he going to need resuscitation? Maradona?
Sis.
Fascinating. Fascinating. And the best commentator ever, Peter Drury, commentating our lives as we speak. Everything has led to the glorious end, this moment now where the African French team takes it to the finals. Yeah! Let me tell you, this African French team is now going to be facing Croatia, yet another underdog team. Miraculous stuff.
Mm. Now, let me tell you something. An underdog team has never won the World Cup. So they've got a tall task ahead of them. And it's really just about which team you favor more than anything else. I'm assuming.
Are you going to tell us you don't favor the team that we think you favor?
I normally support the underdog. That's just who I am.
Bafana Bafana.
Yeah, I mean, Bafana Bafana was in the final.
Bafana Bafana could even play against Banyana nice Banyana.
That's terrible, you guys. Self-loathing. They
I'm
could
just,
do
all
it.
All I'm just saying is when Croatia return our land back to us and our coastline back to the Serbs, I'm talking about European history that no one cares about. But
we
it's
can.
Okay. It's
so
okay.
I'd like to wrap up with some moments that we saw pop up on social media, but maybe we didn't have any time to talk about them on this show that were definitely a highlight. So, do you remember the game that Nigeria won against Iceland?
Mm.
Mm-hmm. Before that, they'd actually first lost to Croatia, who are now in the... I mean, that's huge, Nigeria. Mm. Big ups. So Nigeria decided then to take things into their own hands. And the people back home in the motherland decided to ensure that the Super Eagles take flight. Have a look. We love you, Oga!
Amen.
I've come again. Every power that want to hold our goals today. Father, destroy now. In fact, Okosha, Kanu, you are not using your leg for now. I take your leg. I take your leg. I pass it over to Iwobi. I give it to Mike. I give it to Moses. I give it to Igalo. Take power. Any shot from the post is a goal. Any shot is a goal. Father, Roro Nation, are you ready to pray? Say amen.
Creepy. Right, I guess those prayers did work because Nigeria did end up winning that game 2-0. And it was unfortunate that they lost the next one against Argentina in their next match, of course, and were sent packing. All the chickens, all the jollof rice, all of it had to go back home. But listen, no one is as dramatic as the Barmy Army. Barmy Army! Barmy Army! No. Really, guys?
Sorry.
Barmy Army. Barmy Army. Doom, doom. Bami Ami, doom, doom. Come on, Bami Ami. Boom, boom.
You just had to put some blackness into it and we got it.
Listen, they were chanting. They were doing all sorts of crazy things. They've been doing all the nice things. But did you see this video? It's coming home. It's
coming home.
No, it's not.
An interesting fact, guys. It's coming home is the chorus of three lines by the Lightning Seeds. The song was released in 1996 when England hosted the European Football Championships to poke fun at the lack of international tournament success the country had experienced since winning the World Cup in 1966. The song's lyrics include lines like, England's gonna throw it away, gonna throw it away. You don't like that? I can try it like this. England's gonna throw it away, throw it away. Mm.
Okay. Like it? No.
Thank you. Good.
Thank you so much.
That was amazing.
We appreciate it.
Should I do it again?
No, it's fine.
It's good.
One time is all we need. Right, now the English for Social, they win and they success. That some took it this far. I don't know why.
Wow.
A whole tattoo that says Sir Harry, in brackets we'll call Harry Kane, World Cup winners 2018.
Flop, flop, flop.
And then another one says shame. England 2018 World Cup winners. This guy now has to go make a butterfly tattoo to cover the nonsense he did.
Because we are papa. Urata dillo.
What a flop. Hey. Anyway, so... Now they have a constant reminder of their failures because it's tattooed on their bodies. Unlike me, who has great tattoos.
Oh, yeah. Show us, Lala, show us.
Yeah, no,
actually, how many tattoos do you have?
Lots.
Interesting. Can I find out?
Aye.
All right.
Later. Now, you can find out later, Musa.
Okay, don't sound so sad, Bobby. Anyway, they were such sore losers that they even did this to a poor reporter.
How do you know that reporter was?
Fan coming up to me. It has gone from jubilation. To anticipation. Now it has turned to anger. The English fans are very angry and the ref is just about to call this final whistle. It is Croatia's game, I believe. 2-1.
Croatia has taken the game. Wow. The yobs. He's incredibly professional because he just continues.
That was your friend Jabu.
That's my friend Jabu. Yeah, he's a reporter. Yeah.
She's professional.
And look, after seeing that clip, I'm sure we can all safely say that we really support Croatia in their quest because the fans that belong to the British team are just not it. And of course, one of the guys
I do not share those sentiments. Hashtag just saying.
I'd rather support Banyana and Bafana Bafana than Croatia.
Okay, so much shade. Listen, he was asked, Xe, how did you feel about the match? Your boy was like, it's not coming home, and kept walking. I love it. I love it a lot. Soccer!
Football. Soccer army! Got it? Soccer army! You need to sort this out. We're going to go to an ad break. Let us know what the hashtags are on three. Who you think is going to take this World Cup. 2018's been what a while. We'll be right back.